What's up guys, it's Tyler. Today we've got a how-to and we're gonna show you how to use our ZZP Pulley Puller to install a modular pulley and hub. Fairly straightforward process. Basically you need your M62 or M90 blower. You can either do it on car in some of the 3800 applications. With Ecotec, typically you have to take it off the car. So you have your various pulley puller components. You have the two main plates, along with all the nuts and bolts that it comes with, washers, everything you need is in the box. We offer it two different ways, either brand new so you can keep it, or a rental option so you can use it and send it back. Outside of that, tools you will need are going to be a 15/16 ratchet and socket, and then a wrench. On top of that, you will need a few Allen keys for the modular pulley itself, and then for one of the pieces in the pulley puller. Like I said, you know, either remove the blower or leave it on the car if possible. And then we'll go from there. First step, and this is important, is to apply a good amount of anti-seize to the main bolt. You're going to use that then to thread through one of the plates and then remove the pulley off of the snout. After you've got the anti-seize on the bolt, you are going to thread it through the main triangle plate here. What you want to take note of is that the nut side is away from the end of the bolt. So from there, what we're going to do is assemble the puller itself, which is, again, pretty straightforward. Your horseshoe plate, the cutout or the indent here is going to go onto the pulley itself. You can see there that it kind of houses within there. So once you have the main bolt through, you're going to take these three smaller bolts and assemble the unit. Attach them here so you can put that onto the supercharger. And then you're also going to take your large nut there and thread it onto the rod. And you'll see that it kind of sits in the center there. So then you're going to take the whole unit and place it over the supercharger here. And essentially what you're going to do once we tighten this all down is use this main rod and it's going to pull that pulley outwards. All right. Once you have your pulley puller aligned and on the end of the supercharger snout here, one thing that you need to take note of is a small washer needs to go in between the end of the pulley and the rod there. So you can slip it in and start to tighten down by hand. All right, so once you've got that all on and lined up, it will be quite difficult, especially if you've never removed it before. But basically you're just gonna wrench it off. Now, if you hear any loud pops during, that's normal. That's probably just it unseating itself. And then it'll get easy. We'll just work the hub or the pulley off the hub. And there you are. Our stock pulley is now removed. So now that we have the stock pulley off, you're gonna have the bare snout there. What you're gonna wanna do is make sure that it's all cleaned up. If there's any corrosion, you know, take a Scotch-Brite pad, get that off. To make installation a little easier, you may want to put a dab of oil on there. But from here, we'll show you how to install the modular hub. Same pulley puller is used to install the new hub. First thing you're gonna do is take one of these small bolts. You've got an Allen key on one side and you're gonna thread that into the large 5/8 bolt. All right, so once you have that M8 bolt into the larger 5/8 bolt, you will assemble the pulley installer as so. You're gonna have the flat side headed towards the snout and you're gonna have the nut on the back side. From there, you're gonna install the bearing and the large washer onto that. And then the hub is going to go on there. And we're gonna thread the whole unit into the supercharger snout. making sure not to cross-thread anything. And then you'll notice that the supercharger snout starts to move. That's when your M8 bolt is snug inside of there. Once you have everything installed, you'll see how it sits here. What you're gonna wanna then do is hold your right hand steady with the socket on here and use your 15/16 wrench and tighten this nut clockwise. What that's gonna do is prevent the shaft on the supercharger from moving and spinning the rotor pack, and you can slowly work the hub on. Your goal in the end, and I'll show you once we're finished here, is to line up the end of the hub with the beginning of the snout. All right, once we have the tool off, you can see here that the shaft is flush with the new hub. To install the new pulley, all we're gonna have to do, fit it up against there, and then use our Allen keys and get that snugged on. And then just like your lug nuts go in a star pattern, make sure they're all snug. They don't have to be super tight. Just make sure the pulley's on there. And with that, you have your brand new ZZP pulley on our ZZP modular hub. We'll catch you next time.